now we're here with Jim McFarland, who's the owner of the Wallingford UPS store. Nice to have you here. Can you tell me, what was your first job, and how old were you at the time?
My first job was with my father at age 6. He was a mason contractor. And, you know, it started off with the little things like moving buckets of water and carrying bricks. And I worked with him until I was 21.
So you had that job for a long time. And you got that job through family, right, through your dad?
Yeah, I didn't have much choice.
So you just kind of got dragged into the family business. But were there ever any issues with transportation, since it's a family business?
Really not in the beginning. Once I became old enough to drive, you know, it became a different story altogether. But I pretty much, you know, went to work with dad in the morning and came home with him at the end of the day.
So you had the job for a long time, but when you first had it, when you were 6, do you think you really had any expectations for the job? And did they meet your expectations? Or
at 6 years old, I definitely had no expectations. I mean, I was truly just, you know, glad to be hanging out with dad.
Yeah.
And doing what I could do. It was a learning experience that is hard to measure.
Working with your dad must have been a big deal to you when he first asked you. Do you have any like moments that really stuck out to you as your most memorable experiences?
You know, my dad was a very hard worker, and he gave me a lot of work ethic. And we did a lot of, you know, different things. You know, as a mason contractor, you can't do a lot in the winter, so he plowed snow. And I can remember, you know, I lived across the street from Robert Early, which is now the town hall.
Yeah.
And I was late for school probably 2 days a week because we'd be putting sand on parking lots in the morning. So I was in seventh grade putting sand on parking lots and missing first period.
Yeah.
So yeah, there's a lot of things like that that, you know, stick with me for, you know, ever.
Yeah. So like as a 6-year-old, you have your whole life ahead of you and you have a lot of big ideas. Did you really know what you wanted to be when you grew up? Did you have any big dreams?
Well, I can't say that, you know, I had that, you know, stereotypical, I want to be a fireman, I want to be a policeman. I mean, I'm sure that, you know, that all went through my head at some point and I played, you know, the Cowboys and Indians and stuff throughout. But one of the things that stuck with me growing up was living as close to the center of town. I used to go to Kaplan's Market. And I always liked the hometown feel. They knew who you were. They called you, you know, by your name even as a kid. And they kept it safe. You know, it's very different than it is today. And I always wanted to try and carry on that. So I guess I really kind of thought I was going to own like a small little grocery store like a Kaplan's when I was growing up, and I did go into, you know, a job at Everybody's Market, you know, another local grocery store, but that didn't quite work out.
Having that job for so long with your dad, being in the business, I'm sure you learned many lessons. Did any of them really carry with you into your future careers and make you choose your paths?
my dad's lessons, any of us that worked with him growing up stuck with us. And, you know, it was really very straightforward. Always be respectful of the customer you're working for. Always work as hard as you can. One of his big thing was always try and work smart, not hard. You know, do the job once, not twice. So all of those things have stuck with me and been a good reason to why the UPS store is, you know, still going 19 years strong.
Yeah. So it seems like it's a very good learning experience. So would you say that learning would be like a good word, but what would you say is probably the number one word you'd use to describe your first job with your dad?
Well, there's no doubt that learning was, you know, the biggest thing that took place, but life experiences, you know, came through that, you know, learning to work with other people, learning to deal with the general public, and learning that, you know, if you didn't work, you didn't have any money in your pocket.
Very true. If you could go back and tell your 6-year-old self what path to take, would you say that you would want to tell yourself to take the same course and work with dad again?
Absolutely. I have no regrets of working with my dad. You know, some of my fondest memories are, you know, different jobs that we did, and being in the field that we was in, it's kind of nice because I can drive through town and go, I worked on that. Dad did that building. We, you know, we did the brickwork on that. So there's a lot of pride in what he did, and I carry a lot of that pride in what he accomplished.
With all your pride, would you say that you have any tips for people that might be looking for their first jobs like you were?
Anybody who's looking for a first job, I mean, it's tough out there right now. So you need to do something to separate yourself from the other people coming in. Always, always, you know, dress up, make yourself look professional. Learn about the business you're going in to apply to before you walk in, so that you can carry on a conversation with the interview person and have an idea about what it is that they're asking. It's prepared. Be prepared with whatever you're doing, and be professional.
Thank you. Thank you very much for coming in tonight.